Names of Allah. The names of Allah describe the sublime attributes of our Lord. For example, Allah is the Ar-Rahman, the forgiver. He is the Rab, the teacher and the guide. He is the Al-Hakim, he who issues commandments and rules all things. He is the Ar-Razak, he who gives people their daily bread. Since these names describe Allah, people can better comprehend His greatness, closeness, power, and mercy by praying to Him using these names. It is entirely in line with the meaning of His prayer for someone seeking his daily bread from Allah to pray to Him using His name of Ar-Razzaq. Indeed, we are told in the Quran that one can pray to Him using different names. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. To Allah belong the most beautiful names, so call on Him by them. Nobody who knows the names of Allah will try to conceal his errors from Him, because he knows that Allah is aware of everything, whether he conceals it or puts it out in the open. The believer who knows that covering up his errors will do nothing for him but harm him will always seek forgiveness from Allah for all his mistakes and deficiency. In this film, you will see some of the names of Allah as revealed in the Quran. Al-Basit, he who opens, broadens, or makes plentiful. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Is there anyone who will make Allah a generous loan so that he can multiply it for him many times over? Allah both restricts and expands, and you will be returned to Him. Allah bestows material and spiritual abundance on those who believe in Him and sincerely obey Him. He clears away the difficulties before them and shows that He is the close friend of believers in all they do. The true servants of Allah seek refuge in Him alone and take Him as their guardian in all kinds of trouble, affliction, and sickness. But while Allah makes things easy for believers, He makes them very difficult for non-believers. There are many examples of this in the Quran. For instance, the Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, and the people of Israel who followed him had to flee their homes because of Pharaoh's persecution. But Pharaoh followed them with his army in order to catch them. Trapped between Pharaoh's army and the sea, the Israelites thought they had been caught. This is revealed as follows in the Quran. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. And when the two hosts came into sight of one another, Moses' companion said, "We will surely be overtaken." He said, "Never. My Lord is with me, and He will guide me." Allah heeded the prophet Moses, peace be upon him, prayer, and worked a miracle to divide the sea in two, thus rescuing the Israelites from Pharaoh's hands. He then destroyed Pharaoh and his army, allowing the Israelites to inherit the land they emerged onto. There is no doubt that Allah's promise always has, and always will, apply to all believers. Al-Badi, he who creates using no pre-existing model. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. The originator of the heavens and earth, when he decides on something, he just says to it, "Be," and it is. Human beings have 5 senses, and it is impossible to even imagine the 6th. In addition, they can only use the senses they have in a limited manner. For example, they can only see a specific range of colors or hear sounds of specific frequencies. It is therefore impossible for them to think about, discover, or imagine something that does not exist in this world. When we look at some scientific discoveries, we see that people have taken the living things they have observed in nature as models. For instance, the protruding nose of the dolphin served as a model for the prows of modern large ships. The operating principle of radar is the same as the sensory perception system of bats that emit sound waves. Yet Allah's knowledge is infinite. Almighty Allah has created everything that people see or cannot see around them, using no pre-existing models. Allah created a flawless system made up of atoms, molecules, cells, living things, planets, stars, and galaxies, at a time when no universe, galaxies, planets, living things, or even a single cell existed, simply by commanding it to be. Allah brought the universe and every detail in it into being using no pre-existing model. This is revealed as follows in another verse. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. He is the originator of the heavens and the earth. How could he have a son when he has no wife? He created all things, and he has knowledge of all things. Al-Fatir, the creator, the inventor. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. My Lord, you have granted power to me on earth and taught me the true meaning of events. Originator of the heavens and earth, you are my friend in this world and the next. So take me as a Muslim at my death and join me to the people who are good. The earth is a planet specially arranged for living things to survive on. The earth's position in space and the fact that it is equipped with every detail required to meet the needs of the living things on it are proofs that the planet is a sublime work of Allah's. There are amazing signs of creation in all the living things on Earth. Each one lives in the habitat most suitable for it and with appropriate bodily features. The cell, the essential building block of all living things, is by itself a perfect system with all the organelles inside it. The order inside the cell is so immaculate that it by itself proves the impossibility of life emerging spontaneously. There are signs of a manifest creation in all the details we see or do not see around us. There is no doubt that the features of all of these belongs to Allah, the creator of all things. Allah reveals the perfection of the system he has created in Surah Al-Mulk. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. He who created the 7 heavens in layers, you will not find any flaw in the creation of the All-Merciful. Look again, do you see any gaps? Then look again and again. Your sight will return to you, dazzled and exhausted. Al-Kawi, he who foresees the existence of all things and the forms they will assume throughout that existence, and who creates them accordingly out of nothing. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Allah created every animal from water. Some of them go on their bellies, some of them on 2 legs, and some on 4. Allah creates whatever He wills. Allah has power over all things. All the bees in the hive discharge their responsibilities to perfection. For example, all the worker bees work on building the hive. They also keep the temperature in the hive stable by ventilating it. They bring the foodstuffs they collect from flowers back to the hive. The queen bee, on the other hand, always stays in the hive and constantly reproduces. The gnat that hatches from an egg in no way resembles its adult stage. The larva will shed its skin 4 times before completing its development. The skin opens up towards the end of the pupal stage, and the adult gnat emerges without ever touching water. These creatures are just 2 of the countless life forms on Earth. As with all other living things, Allah has appointed their births, lives, and deaths. From the moment of their creation, they live in the manner ordained and commanded by Allah, and they never step outside the tasks appointed for them by Allah. Camels that live at temperatures of 50 degrees Celsius in the deserts. Penguins that live at minus 30 Celsius at the poles. And sponges thousands of meters below the sea are all in the same situation. They all live in the manner ordained by Allah. The generations that went before also live in the same way, as will all those that come after, because Allah has determined a lifestyle for all life forms. Allah created man from a drop of water and ordained a lifestyle for him too. Nobody can, by himself, decide on his own lifestyle, nor hold off aging and death, nor escape sufferings. Because Allah ordained these events in eternity before people were even aware of their own existence. Al-Halim, the very gentle. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Those of you who turned their backs on the day the two armies clashed, it was Satan who made them slip for what they had done. But Allah has pardoned them. Allah is ever forgiving, all forbearing. Allah sent our Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, down a book from his own presence. That book, whose commandments have been preserved to the present day, is the last divine scripture. In the Quran, Allah reveals commandments that people must abide by and prohibitions they must heed. He has also revealed that those who spend their lives earning his approval will remain in paradise for all time. He also reveals that those who disobey him will spend all eternity in hell, as well as detailed descriptions of the sufferings there. But although they know the Quran is the truth, the majority of people refuse to read it. They ignore the verses sent down to them by Allah and turn instead to the amusements and pleasures of the life of this world. They never think about the account they will have to give of themselves after death and the life of the hereafter. In the same way, they fail to abide by Allah's prohibitions, so they thus fail to live by the moral virtues He commands. They never share their goods or possessions, or help those worse off than themselves, and, when told to believe, they reply, "I know exactly what I'm doing." But Allah, the infinitely compassionate and loving, does not punish those who deny Him immediately. He even allows them to live pleasant lives in this world, and bestows all kinds of blessings on them. He gives them time to believe and turn to the true faith. Allah has shown that He has made Islam easy to live by. He knows how feeble people are, so He does not hold them responsible when they forget or make mistakes. He imposes no responsibilities on the blind, the lame, or the sick. He lifts the load from people's shoulders by teaching them fortitude and submission. Thank you. Adi Yama Bhim, Lord of the Day of Judgment. The Day of Judgment is when people will be resurrected after death, give account of themselves, and see their futures. On that day, nobody will be in any state or have any opportunity to take interest in anyone else, not even their parents, spouses, or children. With the severity and extraordinary fear on that day, everyone will consider himself alone. Allah describes the Day of Resurrection, or the Day of Judgment, in these terms in the Quran. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. What will convey to you what the Day of Judgment is? Again, what will convey to you what the Day of Judgment is? It is a day when a self will have no power to help any other self in any way. The command that day will be Allah's alone. On that day, the relationships that people attach so much value to in this world will fall apart in the face of Allah's wrath. People's relationships and genealogies will no longer mean anything. The only remaining value will be that of faith. This means that all the doors that people expect help from, other than Allah, will be closed. Only Allah can save them from that difficult situation. And that again depends entirely on His will. Allah will create a climate suited to His majesty and glory, and will hold His servants to account. He will save those whom He wishes through His mercy. On that day, when unbelievers suffer the most terrible regret, believers will be happy and joyful. This is set out in another verse in these words. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. On the day when Allah will not disgrace the Prophet and those whose faith along with him. Rabb al-Alamin, Lord of the Worlds. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. All praise belongs to Allah, the Lord of the heavens and the Lord of the earth, Lord of all the worlds, and greatness belongs to Him in the heavens and earth. He is the Almighty, the All-Wise. There are many different worlds in the universe, further subdivided into many other different worlds. There are millions of different types of plants and animals. There are also many different kinds of objects. Winds and clouds also possess different characteristics to one another. Allah has created billions of human beings, none of whom resemble any of the others, all with different races, complexions, languages, and cultures. In addition, Allah has also created the world of the atom, invisible to the naked eye, the cells with their magnificent systems that make up every millimeter of our bodies, and many other life forms wholly invisible to the human eye. As we sleep, or while we are awake and getting on with our own business, Allah constantly controls innumerable different worlds, from the micro world made up of microorganisms, to the macro world made up of the celestial bodies in space. He manages and nourishes them all, and permits them all to survive. Allah reveals that He is the Lord of all the worlds in these words in the Quran. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. It is Allah who made the earth a stable home for you and the sky a dome, and formed you, giving you the best of forms, and provided you with good and wholesome things. That is Allah, your Lord. Blessed be Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. He is the living. There is no God but Him, so call on Him, making your religion sincerely His. Praise be to Allah, the Lord of all the worlds. Allah is not only the Lord of all the countless worlds within the universe, but also of the angels and jinn who live in another time and space. He also created all those entities and made them submit to Him. The worlds created by Allah far surpass the capability of human reason and imagining. They are all works of His creativity, artistry, and infinite might. What people must do is to respond to our Lord, who called on the Prophet Abraham, peace be upon him, to become a Muslim by saying, I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. I am a Muslim who has submitted to the Lord of all the worlds. Surah Al-Baqarah 131. And as commanded in the Quran, they must live for Allah alone. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Say, my prayer and my rights, my living and my dying are for Allah alone, the Lord of all the worlds. As-Sami, the artist, he who creates with infinite beauty. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. You will see the mountains you reckon to be solid going past like clouds, the handiwork of Allah who gives to everything its solidity. He is aware of what you do. Proof of a sublime mind and infinite knowledge can be encountered in every created entity, living or not. There is no doubt that these are all manifestations of our Lord's title of Al-Alim. However, there is another very important characteristic to be seen in all these entities as well. A fine artistry. We can see Allah's title of As-Sami by looking at the delightful appearance, perfection, and fine and delicate artistry in all the things He has created. For example, the human body has been created in a flawless and immaculate form. All our organs are just where they need to be. Our eyes, for instance, are in our heads where we can see everywhere around us. Our heart is in such a place that it is protected by the rib cage. There is a golden ratio that established symmetry in a human being's external appearance. Artists make use of this golden ratio in their paintings, and human beings' mouths, eyes, and noses are located on the basis of this very delicate ratio. Allah has created details in many different life forms in such a way as to reflect His title of As-Sami. None of their external appearances are the same. One can also see Allah's infinite artistry in the plant kingdom. In one verse, Allah reveals, I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan, and also the things of varying colors He has created for you in the earth. Allah has created millions of different kinds of plants and flowers. They all have different scents, shapes, colors, and symmetries. There may be very different varieties of a single flower, say an orchid, with different appearances and colors. Roses come in many different colors, and there are different tones and hues among these colors. These colors, tones, and patterns are all signs of a manifest artistry. Allah shows us the infinite nature of His artistry in these different appearances by creating such a wide and beautiful diversity. Az-Zahir, He who is evident. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. He is the first and the last, the outward and the inward. He has knowledge of all things. The proofs of Allah's existence are evident for any rational person and are spread right through the universe. All systems, from the simplest to the most complex, are full of miracles. Allah cites various examples of these miracles in the Quran. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Have they not looked at the sky above them? How we structured it and made it beautiful, and how there are no fissures in it, and the earth, how we stretched it out and cast firmly embedded mountains onto it, and caused luxurious plants of every kind to grow in it. Surah Qaf 6 and 7. Have they not looked at the birds above them, with wings outspread and folded back? Nothing holds them up but the All-Merciful. He sees all things. Surat Al-Mulk 19. Allah reveals His existence to His servants with other examples cited in the Quran. One of the main characteristics of believers is that they reflect deeply on all they see around them, and thus become aware of the existence and greatness of Allah. And one of the most important characteristics of the believers is that they harbor a great fear of our Lord, to whom they will have to give account in the hereafter, and thus spend their whole lives striving to seek His approval. Allah tells us in the Quran that I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Those who remember Allah standing, sitting, and lying on their sides, and reflect on the creation of the heavens and the earth. Our Lord, You have not created this for nothing. Glory be to You. So safeguard us from the punishment of the fire.